दिस इज अ वॉल्व एक्चुएटर फ्रॉम हनीवेल विद पार्ट नंबर ML7425B6007. इट नीड्स 24 वोल्ट पावर सप्लाई फॉर ऑपरेशन एंड द स्ट्रोक लेंथ आर दिस इज द स्ट्रोक ओके दिस स्ट्रोक लेंथ इज 20 mm फॉर दिस वन सो वी कैन यूज इट विद 20 mm ग्लोब वॉल्व्स. दिस इज मोस्टली यूज विद AHUs एंड द क्लोज ऑफ फोर्स फॉर दिस एक्चुएटर इज 600 न्यूटन. So, our stem, we are valve on this valve, which is installed like this on the valve, and here we have the connections. This is motor, which is used to move this valve up and down, and then we have here connections. These are the connections, and this is diagram for the connections, how to make connections. So, first of all, this is 24 volt signal. Here it is mentioned 24 volt and it is common of 24 volt. Then Y is our control signal. This is 0 to 10 volt signal from BMS to open or close this actuator. And this is common for control and this is feedback. POS, this is position signal. It is going from actuator to the controller. It is also 0 to 10 volt signal. So like this we can make these connections. Here number 1 and 2, these are manual overrides. For example, if there is no signal from BMS or there is any problem on BMS control cable, then by making a jumper from 1 to this grounding and from 2 to this grounding, we can move this actuator valve up and down. So this is for making overrides. Using this knob, we can operate this valve actuator manually if there is no control signal or there is any problem from BMS and we want to open this valve manually, then we can use this knob. Okay, if we rotate, as you can see here, this will be, the stem will be rotating. So this is actually a spring return actuator, so it will come back automatically. So like this we can rotate. Okay, FCU valve and actuator. This is VC6013 from Honeywell VC series. Here we have a two-way valve installed on this actuator. Actually, this is coming as a complete assembly. Valve actuator and the valve are coming as a complete assembly. Okay. It is a floating type actuator. Here are the connections. Okay. You need a SPDT control to make these connections. We have this wire. Okay. Three points. Three wires we have. This blue one is common. Blue one is neutral. Okay. And we are providing closed signal on brown cable and open signal on black cable. So this is how we make it is a SPDT controller. So we need one signal to open this damper actuator and another signal to close this damper actuator. So keep this in mind while selecting a thermostat for this application. You shall select a thermostat which is compatible and it shall be able to make floating control. Now we have another actuator. This is also from the VC series. This is coming as alone as an actuator, but this is a two position control actuator. Okay, it's not a floating actuator. Previously we had floating actuator. It is a two position. Here we have blue is same neutral, and we have black open and close signal, and brown is directly connected to the power supply. This is a 24 volt actuator. So while you are selecting a thermostat for this FCU, keep in mind that FCU shall support 24 volt signal and it shall be two position control. For this actuator, we have a separate valve. It is a two-way cage valve. So to make the installation for this valve, we can install like this. Just you have to bring it here in the circle and press. After that, just you have to rotate. This valve is now installed. Okay, so to uninstall, just you will rotate this one. After pressing, this is a lock button. So after pressing this lock button, just you will rotate and it will come out. So like this, you will install actuator on the valve. This is FCU thermostat from Honeywell. This is standalone thermostat, which is not connected to the BMS. It is only controlling the FCU locally and it is installed inside the zone. This is two position thermostat. To select a thermostat, it is very important to know what is the power supply it is supporting. This is 230 volt or 120 volt thermostat. Okay, and it is this is for two pipes application. Two pipe application means either you can use it for heating or cooling. You cannot use it for both heating or cooling. That's a four pipe system. For connections, here we have cables out, coming out. Okay, so first of all, this black cable, it is for power supply hot, okay, live, and this white cable is for power supply neutral. Okay, then this orange cable, this is for cooling of heater or the cooling valve. Then these three cables are to control three speeds of the fan. This red cable is for low speed, blue cable is for medium speed, and brown cable is for high speed of the fan. So three cables for fan, one for the heater or the cooling coil, and then this is power supply. This is how you will make connections for an FC's thermostat. This is a water pressure transmitter to give static pressure value. It is installed in the pipes. Here is the connection to the pipe. Stud is welded on the pipe and this then mounted directly on the stud. Here we have the connections. It provides us 4 to 20 milliampere signal. Okay, to make the connections, here we have the connection ports. So it is installed in this pressure port is this connection port is installed here, and then this is for to bring the cables, and then we install it here like this. For this one, we need a DC power supply because it is a 4 to 20 milliampere signal. So we need a DC power supply to give to energize this pressure transmitter. I will show you the connections on the screen. So as BMS is mostly using 0 to 10 volt signal, while this pressure transmitter provides 4 to 20 milliampere signal. So in order to convert 4 to 20 milliampere signal to 0 to 10 volt signal, we need a resistance. Its value shall be around 470 or 500 ohms. So I will show you the detailed connection on my screen. This is outdoor temperature and humidity sensor. This is protection guard to protect it from the climate, from ice, from direct sunlight. So this is a protection guard installed directly on this sensor. We will remove this one and we will see what's inside. So this is our protection guard. After removing this protection guard, we will remove the cover. This is electronics board where we are measuring the temperature and processing all the data. So here we are measuring temperature sensor, temperature and humidity value. There are two options for the power supply. We can use 24 volt DC power supply or 24 volt AC power supply. We mostly use 24 volt AC, so we will connect it in number 2 power supply. And then here is the common on number 7, we will put common. Then for temperature sensor, there is option NTC20K. So this is as we discussed in our input devices video. I will give the link in description. The NTC means this is negative temperature coefficient. This is a thermistor. Okay. But for humidity, we have 0 to 10 volt signal. This is relative humidity, which will be connected on number 6 and between the number 6 and common. It will give us 0 to 10 volt signal corresponding to the 0 to 100% relative humidity. So this is how we make connections for outdoor temperature and humidity sensor. This is duct temperature and humidity transmitter from Honeywell. The part number is H7015B1060. Since it is a transmitter, so it provides a 0 to 10 volt signal for humidity, and also for the temperature, we need a 0 to 10 volt signal. And we also need a power supply. We can use 24 volt DC or 24 volt AC power supply for this transmitter. This is the probe which goes inside the duct. This is mounting flange. Okay, here we have an arrow showing the direction of the airflow. So we install this mounting flange on the duct, and then we insert this humidity sensors inside this duct. There is a screw here to loose. So like this, we can insert this humidity sensor inside the duct. And then regarding the connections, here we have number 1 and 2, we need 24 volt DC or AC power supply. On number 3, we will get a 0 to 10 volt signal for humidity. And on number 4, we will get a 0 to 10 volt signal for the temperature. So this is a air temperature and humidity sensor for installation inside ducts. This is air filter, and from here it is sensing our temperature and humidity. This is the sensing element, our temperature sensor and humidity sensor installed here. So when air will pass through this sensor, it will detect the temperature and humidity value of the sensor. This air filter is replaceable, or after some time, if there it is clogged or there is any problem, it can be replaced. This is an immersion temperature sensor which is installed inside the pipes to measure temperature of the chilled or hot water. The part number is VF21B54 from Honeywell. Here this is our immersion well which is installed directly inside the pipe using these screws. And then after that, this temperature sensor is directly inserted to this immersion well like this. Okay, and here since it's a thermistor and it's NTC20K, we have only two connections, and we need a two core cable for making a connection here. It is a passive sensor, we don't need any power supply for this one since it's a thermistor. This is room or zone temperature sensor. It is installed inside the conditioned spaces to measure the temperature of our zone or conditioned space. This is TR21 sensor from Honeywell. It is a thermistor type sensor, NTC20K. Here we have two points cables for connection only, as it is a thermistor and we don't need any power supply. This is our temperature sensing element, which is a thermistor. So this is using this is sensing our temperature and giving us variable resistance, which is changing with the temperature value.